speeds away.
I've wept for those who suffer long, but how I weep for those who've gone. In rooms of grief and questioned wrong, but keep on killing. It's in the soul to feel such things, but weak to watch without speaking. Oh, what mercy sadness brings, if God be willing. There is a train that's heading straight to heaven's gate, to heaven's gate. And on the way, child and man and woman wait, watch and wait for redemption day. Fire rages in the streets and swallows everything it meets. It's just an image often seen on television.
Hey everyone, Joe here. Just doing our intro to our Terry Thacker Sr. Tribute build. As many of you already know by now, lost Sr. A few weeks ago. And I didn't put up a video at the time. I think others were covering it pretty well. So I didn't get a chance to hang out in a lot of the lives that would go on or things like that. Just the time doesn't permit for me. But whenever I did get a chance, Senior would be one of the first ones to say hello, how are you doing, always offer a kind word, etc. So definitely wanted to get into this tribute build being hosted by Brian over at Got Fuels and Fred Henry over at West Georgia Rods and Customs. Two great guys as well. And so what I've decided to do, since you can kind of do anything, and I know Terry actually flew aircraft, so what I've decided to do for him is this P-51A. I figured he was a Mustang guy. He had to have been quintessential fighter, right? So we're going to do this accurate miniatures, 1/48 scale, P-51A. Haven't done an accurate miniature kit before. I do know they can be really great. They were ahead of their time for sure. So we'll get this box open. It's kind of cool they got box art on both sides. Let's open. Everything's still in plastic, but did go out and get the decals from STS. Guys over here at STS got them, man. Terry here shipped it out really, really quick. So got that and pretty excited about them. Think we're gonna try and definitely use, you guys can see here, we're gonna try and probably use 56 if it's in scale for the tail, and we'll use some nose art. I'm not sure which one, either Kiss My Ass or one of the other nose arts that's in there. So these are actually. These are a brilliant idea, by the way. I mean, super, super smart idea. Covers everything that you could build with a tank, aircraft, car, truck. You could put these on anything. Got a couple extras for this. There's the quick boost exhaust set. And then these are, I bought these a long time ago. Sprue Brothers will do a clearance sale and they'll have accurate miniature decals. Because these kits are rather old, they can have yellow decals, and they're 99 cents on Sprue Brothers when they do that. So I picked up a set just in case. Got our mask, of course, and all of our plastic parts, like I said, in the bag. Recessed panel lines, again, accurate miniature is pretty good. And then under here should be clear parts. Decals. Ooh, these ones actually look good, so we're gonna be all set. We'll have a spare set of P-51 Mustang A's and instruction sheets. Now, look, the one thing about accurate miniatures, I will tell you all, if you get one and you haven't built one, but from watching others, the way that they do their instructions is they're written out here on the side. Okay. And you need to read this. Don't go by the pictures. You need to read what's written out on the side. Otherwise, something can go wrong. Just trying to do the pictures doesn't really work. So that was one thing I did learn. Should be interesting. Should be a lot of fun, though. The P-51A, that the only one for this would have been the A-36 Apache, which we also have from Accurate Miniatures. That would be a fun build too, but we're going to get this one built up for Terry and yeah, should be good. So that's all I've got for now. We'll come back here with a little bit of an update as we go through and see what we can do. Probably more of like a build series all in one video with the final at the end. So that's what I'm kind of planning. That could change in a moment's notice, though. So, all right, everyone. So we are back, and we have our cockpit finished. I just wanted to show it off before we put it all together here. This Accurate Miniatures kit is simple, but kind of neat. I really like it. It reminds me of one of the older Tamiya kits. So the Corsairs, Zero. That early 90s era kit, and it's pretty simple, which is nice. Few parts, but everything seems to fit nicely. Everything's nicely keyed. Again, you got to read the instructions, not just go by the pictures. But here's what we got so far, and you can kind of see what I've done, and I'll explain, because we've got a zoom in. We did it in a dull dark green, which is the same color for a Corsair. And the reason for that was, in doing some of the research, I found that the very early Mustangs, this P-51A or the Apache A-36, would have been this dull dark green possibly, and not really what you would see as an interior green. So and a little floorboard. Now, the interesting part about the floorboard is that it's actually the top of the wing spar. So this is the top of the wing. No, this is the top of the wing spar. It goes right across. And that's just kind of where the floorboard was. So we've also got the instrument panel done and decaled. No quintesset for this aircraft, unfortunately. We've got our seat in with the seat belts. The seat belts were part of this it's Kit Worlds decal, the USAAF fighter set. Tends to work out pretty well. For this one, I just took a couple and cut them. You're supposed to cut these to size anyway, so did a couple of that. And then for some of the placards that are in there, added this air scale. Ooh, can't see it. This air scale W2 Allied cockpit, and just kind of put some like on the sides here, especially here. You can kind of see them just to give it something. It's got a large glass area, so you'll be able to see a little bit in there, not too much, but. And we have our radio equipment to go in. And you can see we did some post shading. Just trying that out, having some fun with it. We've got our propeller done. And then, while I have the camera, I'm going to zoom out a little bit. And basically show you. So, for a reference, we actually have both of the part one and part two for the detail and scale P-51 Mustang. And then they have the A in here, of course, along with the A-36 Apache, which I have and I'm kind of accurate miniatures kit of, and I'm kind of itching to build after this one. It's, like I said, I really like this kit. but definitely not accurate, right? So, you know, what you could do if you were better than me is put this piping in. There's some piping that's supposed to go under the seat. You can see this is not interior green. This is that dull, dark green. Especially, I think over here looks a little bit better. That is the dull, dark green. But you can see the side. See here the side panels. It has this hump and extra. And, you know, obviously, this doesn't have that. And this is supposed to be part of the wing spar. The cockpit floor goes underneath it. But, you know, again, that's okay. I'm not going to fuss about it. And then it's funny to me that the seat is yellow zinc chromate, which I don't really think it would have been. That just kind of seems, you have to be careful with the restored aircraft sometimes because they will throw stuff in there. But I don't think the seat would have been in zinc chromate. Maybe it would have. If someone out there knows, let me know. You can see the seat's not really accurate either. It doesn't have the places for the holes on the sides and things like that. But again, not really a big deal for me personally. Just interesting to see. Like, I'm curious where they took their scans or however they did their CAD of this, because there's obviously a P-51 out there. They must not have done image scanning back then. But and again, you can see on this sidewall there's so much stuff missing. Again, not a big deal at all. And I think what we're gonna do next is smash this thing all together. And then do what I did kind of with the Spitfire, come back in the next video after it's all together. Show it off a little, see if there's any flaws, and then throw it into paint. Again, this is for the, you know, Terry Thacker Sr. tribute build. So I know Brian over at Got Fuel's Garage has a playlist going. So if you want to check out everybody else's, you can go check out that playlist of his and see all the cool builds that are being done. And we're going to be doing this in a made up scheme, just so everyone knows. I think I touched on that earlier, but we're going to do it. I think I'm going to explain it once I get there. Actually, I'll keep it a surprise. But it will be a made up scheme, obviously, using the senior decals that I got from STS. So, all right, I'm taking up enough of your time. Until next time, everyone, I hope you're doing well. I hope you're staying safe. Take care.
Freedom. Freedom.